inside India's unlisted companies.
I've always wondered what the faces behind the voices that grab my attention in ads look like.
UTVI.
So I decided to catch up with voice artist Niji Chhabra. Over the past 5 years, Niji's lent her voice to many popular commercials.
What does it require to become a good view artist? What are the skills that you really need to come with into the industry?
The most important thing is that you have to be a good voiceover artist, you have to observe a lot, watch a lot of things, read a lot, because then your diction has to be perfect.
The voice industry's come a long way, from the days of just one Amin Sayani to a variety of voice artists today working in film and TV dubbing, channel and TV promos, ads, radio, documentary films and telecom industry.
Because I left 10 girls because of that bad reason.
Do voice artists have to lead a very disciplined life? Because, you know, they need to maintain the quality of their voice because that's the selling point.
You need proper sleep. Because otherwise, most of the time you spend in cleaning your throat. Then this thing happens with you. So you need proper sleep, at least 7, 8 hours, 6 hours.
High tempo. Okay.
Apart from knowing the techniques, one requires great networking skills and loads of confidence to back those great projects.
ShopRite gives you the access to anything in the world that you shop for.
And helping aspiring voice artists learn both is renowned voice artist Darpan Mehta. Darpan's the voice of many famous channels, Nat Geo docus, and today's turn his experience into honing great voices.
Tujh sang preet lagai sajna, 3 November se aapke apne channel. Star Plus Par.
Darpan, is it necessary for a voice artist to go through formal induction and training?
You did have a Kishore Kumar who was a genius, who didn't undergo any formal training. But how many Kishore Kumars do we have in life? So you need training to be a voice actor as much as you need training to be a doctor or to be an engineer.
Training may be your requirement if you're looking for some guidance, but there are many who start out on their own. Others, like Sunil and Darpan, come from a background of TV or theatre. The voice industry works largely on a freelance basis, with artists demanding variable figures depending upon their talent and the nature of work. While TV or radio assignments can pay you anything between 3,000 to 10,000 rupees, dubbing assignments vary between 1,500 rupees to 3,000 rupees per episode.
Experience the joy of stepping into heaven.
4 different characters at one go, you know. Nobody needs to know it's the same person or not. How many people are playing, nobody needs to know that. And it's such a different, it's such a dynamic profession that one can enjoy, one can be themselves, one can make funny faces. And it will not seem funny or it will not seem strange to an outsider.
No wonder then that voice artists are also called voice actors. I'm a bit envious of these guys and you should be too. That is, if you'd love to be in a profession that gives you a fantastic opportunity to be whoever you want to. Or at least, sound like it.
Sab log aakar mujhse poochte hain ki aapne aspatal mein apna waqt kaise kaata.